À l'époque, je travaillais avec Raphaël sur un autre projet, et en lui rendant visite à Paris dans son studio, je me suis rendu compte que Nick et lui avaient vraiment des influences similaires.
I think skateboarding's influenced my own work because of the way I view the world. I've always thought about things in a creative way, and skateboarding's really encouraged that. So I make paintings, and it makes me feel similar in terms of like exploring composition form in the same way as discovering new spots in the city and meeting new people. Raphael's quite a brave artist because he sort of steps outside of convention. He's trying to look at that historic language and reinterpret it. He's trying to use skateboarders as a vehicle to explore new territory within his practice.
In a way, the project started a couple of years ago when I did the journey to Germany to visit a kind of museum of science in the Faculty of Mathematics. I was very interested with plaster objects made by a German mathematician called Arthur Schoenflies at the end of the 19th century. And this guy was a mathematician and a crystallographer. He worked on something you called paving space. It's a tessellation, but in three dimensions. So we invented different type of geometrical modules that you can assemble to pave space. When I discovered the module that Schoenflies designed, I was working on a series of sculptures called the prismatics. And it's a series where I assembled some pieces of wood, some kind of triangles together. And I was a little bit stuck because I could produce only flat sculptures, almost in 2D. But the modules that Schoenflies did that were somehow similar in the shape, I thought they could really help me to go in three dimensions, to go beyond the two-dimensionality of my prismatic sculptures. The advantage of Schoenflies modules was that I could assemble and fill space out of it, like working really like a sculpture in 3D.
Les maquettes représentent un dialogue entre Raphaël et Skater. Il essaie de trouver les meilleurs arrangements esthétiques, et nous, de notre côté, on s'efforce de trouver les meilleures structures skatables. Certaines ressemblent plus à ce qu'on pourrait trouver dans la rue, mais d'autres sont beaucoup plus irréalistes, on les trouverait jamais dans un environnement architectural. Oui, en effet, articuler des modules en trois dimensions, ça nous donne la liberté pour créer quelque chose d'unique pour le skateboard. Ouais, on se rend compte que l'espace dans lequel la sculpture est installée définit son interprétation par les skateurs, évidemment, mais aussi par le public. L'espace et les maquettes sont pour nous comme des variables qu'on utilise pour déterminer l'emplacement des modules. Par exemple, un long et étroit espace nous force à créer plus de sculptures et les mettre les unes après les autres. Ouais, en revanche, un espace plus grand et plus rond nous forcera à faire une sculpture plus centrale, qu'on pourra aborder de différents angles.
I think for Raphael, he's interested in having a variety of people skating his sculptures. Every skater involved in the project has a completely different take on Raphael's work.
Moi, ce qui m'a vraiment impressionné, c'est de voir des idées complètement différentes se rencontrer et rencontrer aussi celle de Raphaël et ensemble donner naissance à une idée nouvelle, inédite. L'opportunité d'avoir la sculpture montrée dans différents endroits du monde la garde vivante.
When you introduce skateboarding into the equation, it changes people's perception about what architecture and what space is.
Un visiteur lambda pourrait très bien aller au musée et voir l'installation comme un objet d'art en soi. Et grâce à ça, Raphaël altère les préconceptions du public sur la définition de l'art.
There are so many people doing composition of squares and circles. Like, what can you add to this? And in a way, I'm a frustrated formalist. I don't really believe only in a formal language. What's really important is that skaters are really helping me to resolve a problem. It's motion that creating the space or that creating a structure, a geometrical structure. If I had to describe the sculpture, it's really a question of the geometry of motion.
Je pense que les natures mêmes du travail de Raphaël et du skateboard rendent les possibilités infinies.